Hi, this is Scott Cartwright.
And this is Dr. Rudy Cartwright, the MS Health Coach.
And we want to thank you for checking out this video. You're here to find out what you can do to get rid of your MS fatigue. And we're going to talk to you about what's causing some of your MS fatigue and what you can do about it. But before we jump into that, just a little bit of information about us. As I said, my name is Scott Cartwright. I have a master's degree in public health, and I work with people and their diseases all day on a daily basis. And I'm also the founder and creator of MS Health University, and I put the site together because MS affects me personally. My wife has MS, and we deal with the ups and downs that go along with that on a daily basis.
Dr. Cartwright again. I'm a brain surgeon and an expert in multiple sclerosis. And if you're wondering what a brain surgeon knows about multiple sclerosis, well, I have over 35 years of training and experience. And during that time, I've seen my share of brain injuries and spinal cord injuries because of, car accidents, truck accidents, motorcycle accidents, bicycle accidents, football accidents, and what have you. And what occurs to the spinal cord and brain during those kinds of injuries over a short period of time occurs in multiple sclerosis over an extended period of time. Now, why am I so passionate about multiple sclerosis? Well, my lovely daughter-in-law was in the middle of her medical school training several years back and was diagnosed with MS. And my son got on the horn, got on the phone, called me and said, Dad, I don't have good news. And I said, oh, don't worry, I know what to do about that. And so that sent me back to the library doing a great deal of research and so forth. And I put together a program for her that she followed, and I'm happy to say that she finished her medical school training, and now she is in the middle of her residency training doing quite well. And that's where I was willing to leave it. And then one day, my son walked in and said, Dad, you got to share this information with others who are recovering from multiple sclerosis. And I said, no way. No way, Jose. I'm not interested in the limelight. And he kept hammering on me and hammering on me and hammering on me, and I finally gave in. And so I've been putting together other programs for other recoverers, and I want to share some of that information with you. And here's a copy of my 5 years of neurosurgery training at Baylor College of Medicine. And so what can we do to help you get rid of your MS fatigue?
And before you let us know that, I just need to let you know that Dr. Cartwright is a medical doctor with over 35 years of training and experience, but the information we're sharing with you today is for informational purposes only and should not be considered as medical advice. Dr. Cartwright has not seen you as a patient and cannot give you medical advice, so whatever you do, please be sure to consult your doctor before you make any changes to your medical routine. And with that, let's find out what you can do about your MS fatigue.
First, let me give you my approach. And on this particular slide, there are three articles. And at the top, I give you the name of the article, the title, and then the authors. And then I give the main points here, which are in blue. And so, as indicated here on this slide, multiple sclerosis is rampant in terms of fatigue. And the other point about this slide is that obstructive sleep apnea is big time in terms of fatigue. And what do you do about that? When you're diagnosed with obstructive sleep apnea, then your doctor will put you on what is called CPAP, or continuous positive airway pressure.
And the middle article where it says OSA, that's obstructive sleep apnea?
That's correct.
And that's very common. So obstructive sleep apnea is common when you have MS. It just means you have a problem when you're sleeping, you're not breathing properly.
That's right. You may not be breathing constantly. You have a stoppage of your breathing. Then pretty soon you'll start to breathe again. At any rate, when they put you on CPAP, you get better.
And you get diagnosed with obstructive sleep apnea from your doctor. Your doctor's office does that for you?
Yeah, they'll order the test for you.
Okay.
Okay?
Great.
All right. And now here's an article that indicates that when you have fatigue, you may have a low level of carnitine. And carnitine is very important in terms of helping your body generate energy. And so what you want to do is do what? Put in carnitine, which is a dietary supplement. All right, what are the action steps? Number one, I really urge you to consider getting checked for sleep apnea.
And like I said, that's at your doctor's office.
That's at your doctor's office. And number two, I'd like to see you start taking carnitine 500 milligrams twice every day.
And can you tell us real quickly what that carnitine will do in your body?
And that carnitine will help your body make energy. Actually, it will help the mitochondria, which is the engine of all the cells in your body. It will help that engine generate energy.
All right, great. Well, we hope you found that information to be helpful and useful. Make sure you follow those recommendations. And if you like this kind of information, be sure to visit us at www.mshealthuniversity.com, or you can click on the link down in the description section. That'll take you over to our site where you can get some more free training videos that go into a lot greater depth about all the things that you can do to get rid of or to continue to get rid of your MS symptoms. So we hope you like this information. We had a great time sharing it with you, and here's to your health.